commencement. He's going to be our worship leader today. Let's receive him now with hearty applause.
John Arbleck. Thank you. morning thanking you.
Thank you.
For being a great God.
Thank you.
We come this morning, Lord, thanking you for being a good God.
Thank you.
Lord, we come thanking you for being the God of second chances.
Thank you.
Well, God, we just come this morning thanking you. Lord, I'm not asking for anything. I'm thankful that you stationed the angels over us while we stumbled and slept.
Thank you.
That you touched us this morning with the finger of love. You woke us closed in our right minds with the active use of our limbs, Master, and for that we are truly grateful.
Yes.
Well, God, I pray right now that you would move on the altars of hearts right now. Well, God, I pray that you would let the anointing of the Holy Spirit fall fresh in this place. Well, God, so we can truly see how great thou art. So we can say, God, it was you. Nobody but you that took us through a week of danger seen and unseen.
Thank you.
Allowing the first wheels to roll but did not stop by our state place. So again, thank you. Well, God, I pray right now that you will just continue to let us know that you are God all by yourself. Help us to realize, Master, that time is not as long as it has been. Without a change, we cannot or will not be saved. Help us to realize, Master, that it's not about us, but it's about you. God, and that you give the glory. Master, that we are to bear one another burdens. Sometimes it's hard, Lord. We don't know. But a kind word, a smile, would brighten somebody's day. I continue, Lord, to pray for our pastor. Continue to pray for his spouse. Continue to pray for the offsprings of their bodies. And Master, for those that you brought out of the hospital, allow them to walk into this place. Thank you. Lord, if I had 10,000 tongues, I would use everyone right now just to give your name the glory and the honor that you so richly deserve. Because as they always would say, if justice had plumb the mind, we all would have been cut off and gone. So thank you for grace and mercy.
Thank you.
Well, God, I pray right now that you would look on those that are in the hospital, those that are in the nursing home, Master, those that are behind prison wall, Master, those that have fallen by the wayside.
Mercy.
We lift them up to you right now in the name of Jesus. And then, Master, I pray that you would forgive sins that have been committed by omission or commission. Because your words declare that if we would confess them, you would be just to forgive us. So blot them out, Lord, so they will not condemn us in days to come. And then, Master, I pray that when we have done everything that you've assigned on our hands to do, when we have to swap time for eternity when it will be no more, that you will meet us and greet us. And give us that admittance into your kingdom. It's your servant's prayer in Jesus' name. Let every heart say amen.
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 Happy New Year. Did you know that Beaufort County School District Adult Education Program is working hard to help individuals obtain their GED, a high school diploma? I can go on about the difference it will make in your life to obtain an academic credential. Please feel free to call me at 843-322-0780 if I can be of service to you. Respectfully, Dr. Lolita Morell, Director. Allen Chapel AME Church, Burton, South Carolina. Are you ready for some football? To the pastor and members of Campbell Chapel AME, greetings to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Allen Chapel AME Church family invites you to join us at our first football Sunday event. The kickoff is Sunday, January 28, 2018 at 3 p.m. The Allen Chapel AME Stadium is located at 16 Shelter Church Road in Burford, South Carolina. Come dressed in your favorite football team's jersey, t-shirt, cap, or real banner. The quarterback speaker for this event is Reverend Don Robinson, pastor of St. Stephen AME Church in Parkville, South Carolina. We look forward to seeing you at this fun-filled and stadium-packed event. Oh yeah, there will be a tailgate after service. May the grace of God be with you, Reverend Dr. Charles C. McLemore, pastor, and Reverend Marcia Jones, local deacon chairperson. Zion AME Church, Hendersonville, South Carolina. Dear pastor, officers, and members of Campbell Chapel AME Church, greeting in the joy of Jesus. It's truly a blessing to be able to gather once again at our annual 12 programs. On behalf of our pastor, Darrell L. Green, and members of Zion AME Church, we are extending an invitation to your church family to join us as we celebrate our annual 12 Tribe Program. Our program will be held on Saturday, February 3rd, 2018, at 4 o'clock p.m. at Zion AME in Hendersonville, South Carolina. We look forward to this annual fellowship, and we are anticipating a spirit-filled time in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you are unable to attend, please assist us by sending a donation. If you have any questions, please contact our chairperson, Horace Garrett, at 843-549-2687. In his service, Reverend Darrell L., pastor, and Brother Horace Garrett, chairperson. Dear pastor and church congregation, the Bluffton Area Community Association is hosting its 7th annual Community Easter Egg Hunt on Saturday, March 31st, 2018 at Bluffton High School, located at 1218 McCracken Circle in Bluffton. We are asking for your support with this free event for our youth in the community to provide either of the items listed below, a monetary donation, food, eggs, plastic, or hard-boiled candy, Easter baskets, as giveaways. Last year, the support and donations helped us provide over 8,000 Easter eggs, 75 Easter baskets, hot dogs, and drinks to over 300 kids along with their families. Campbell Chapel AME, with your donation again this year, we will have another fun and eventful community Easter egg hunt here in Bluffton. Thanking you in advance for your outpouring support and donations. Sincerely, Sharon Brown, BACA Chairperson. The Bluffton High School baseball team is hosting the 5th annual Sam Boosie Bennett All Sports Clinic. The clinic will be held on Sunday, March 11th at 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. The cost is free and it will be located at the Bluffton High baseball field at 12 H. McGrath.
circle in Bluffton, South Carolina. Now on to the announcements in your bulletins. There are three events happening today. January 21st, the trustee board is scheduling a cleanup day within the next 30 days. We are requesting that all members remove any personal property from within the church no later than Friday, February 23rd, 2018. All items remaining after this date will be considered as unwanted property and will therefore be destroyed. Thank you for your assistance in improving our church home. All members are asked to provide the property manager, Sister LaGree, with their 2018 calendars. This will ensure your requested date and times are reserved for the usage of the facility. Please send all requests to jackie.legree@gmail.com or call 843-384-0642. Also today, class number 10 will meet after service. On January 28th, the scholarship committee will meet after service on the fourth Sunday. On Tuesday, January 30th at 7 p.m., the class leaders have their meeting. And on February 4th, every Sunday until February 4th, Super Bowl of Caring will be accepting canned goods and monetary donations in the Narthex to benefit Bluffton's self-help after service. That concludes the announcements. Now we would like to move on to the celebrations. If you are celebrating your birthday in the month of January, would you please stand up?
Otherwise, try to drink water. So that coat that we were talking about, the typical person is supposed to have about a 2,000 calorie diet. So that's about 10% of your diet in one drink. I don't want to drink 10% of my diet. I'd rather eat something I like. So just kind of keep that in mind. And then some of you guys are thinking, well, I don't want to drink a little teeny tiny can of soda. There can't be that much sugar in that. This is in the little 12-ounce. That's about 10.5 teaspoons of sugar. And the same thing is in that bottle of sweet tea because, oh, that's not soda. That's just tea. It's okay. But it has sugar in it. So what I would recommend that you do is most things have these lovely little labels on them. They're nice and small and blended in, but it will tell you. So you can look and see what's the serving size. Because this says serving size of one bottle, 200 calories. But other things may say serving size is 8 ounces. And then you have to do math. Because then you have to multiply because what's over here is going to be more than what it says. So when you see total carbohydrates, you can pretty much count that as sugar. So just kind of be mindful. And if you were a diabetic and you had, you know, that little can of soda, it would be about 1.5 units of insulin to cover your can of soda. So just keep that in the back of your mind. And then some of you are thinking, oh, diet soda, yay, that's just like water. Well, it still has caffeine, especially this Diet Coke, and it has artificial sweeteners. So you just want to kind of be careful with that too. So just kind of balance it out. Made it. There's no sugar, there's no salt, there's nothing, there's no calories. You can just drink as much of this as you want, no guilt, nothing, it's just water. So if you get thirsty, try to drink water. Now some of you have one other thing that you like to try to say, well, you know, I drink Gatorade, so that's better. Well, it may be a little bit less sugar, but there's salt in there. So Gatorade is kind of a rehydrating fluid, you know, and then other things like, well, my child plays sports, so they have to have Gatorade. No. Now, if they're playing football with like 90-degree weather, full pads, they might need Gatorade. But if they're playing soccer and it's reasonable degrees, water works fine. So, message for today is just rethink your drink. If you can't tolerate the plain water, throw a, you know, lemon in it or a cucumber in it, but overall, it'll be the best thing for your body. So, have a great day.
Running after you. You should be running after the board. You will have your 2 minutes.
stuff in every little nook and every little cranny. And so look at the stuff that's in the church. And if you want to take something back that you donated to the church, that's okay. That's okay. I don't know why we're going to get rid of all this stuff, but we're going to give you about 30 days or more. We're not in a hurry, but we want to get this stuff out. And then we're going to clean. Old-fashioned spring cleaning cleaning. You have books that you donated, and you love those books, and you don't want to see them get thrown away in the cleaning. Take them back, sell them, give them to someone. But when the day comes for cleaning, we're going to clean. And you do that in your home, don't you? Then you get mad when the pastor throws out that book you donated. We don't want you to get mad. Let's work together, okay? Amen?
Amen.
Oh, not so strong. Can I get a good amen?
Amen.
Amen. You heard a preacher up and said, throw it out, throw it out. It's a fire hazard. That's the big issue. Some of this stuff is a fire hazard. Right after services today, Fat Tuesday tickets will be at the secretary's desk along with calendars. You Fat Tuesday free. It is free. You know we have a good time on Fat Tuesday. We'll have to sign for your tickets. Last year, people grabbed tickets. We didn't know who had tickets. We don't care about your tickets. We just need to know who has them in case we need to call you and say, do you really need 10 tickets? Can you live with 8? We're preparing for 150, and we want to see 150. Singles Ministry meeting on Tuesday. That's one of our new premier ministries. We want to get everybody who can be involved with singles to be involved with singles. Singles is trying to rival married couples ministry. And I want them to do it. So show up on Tuesday, 7 o'clock, and then finally don't forget our day of prayer and our Bible study. I know we have a long announcement time. So before I sit down, we got to give God a high praise. And we're a busy church. And God is doing great things. Give them all the praise.
We celebrate our Lord in return.
you, O Lord.
Thank you. confusion.
Thank you.
comedian can testify that down